I didn't have that experience. I just watched the videos like some of us did. But some people died for us to be able to drive the bus. Some people died for us to be able to vote and be presidents of the United States. So we got to learn how to come out of this old shell and I don't feel like doing this and start asking, Lord, help me to be a better me. Work on my mind. Kill my attitude. I'm tired of being lazy. I'm tired of being overweight. I'm tired of being depressed and feel like I'm defeated. I'm reading my Bible, but it seems like I'm still distressed and distraught. Why? Because we don't want to step outside of the comfort zone. But if you be willing to step outside of the comfort zones of life, you can tap into some stuff and you can possess that promised land that God has told to the children of Israel that they're going to actually obtain. And they didn't actually obtain it until Joshua chapter 6. But the original generation had died because God just got fed up. Since God would get fed up, he will. He'll get fed up. And there's only two original people out of those millions of people that made it into that promised land with Joshua and Caleb. And if we be willing to learn to let go some things and step outside of the box, then we can get the out-of-the-box blessings. Let us stand. Amen. 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 I'm going to say this. Some people may laugh and some people may whatever. For years, my father told me, go to school. Go to school, you make something in your life. I fought it, worked on jobs, making $15 an hour. I'm gonna work my way up like everybody else, like the superintendent. I'm gonna work my way up, get 20 years, and retire by the time I'm 42. Yeah, I'm gonna work my way up. Yeah, listen to what the boss said, listen, then I'm the first one to get laid off. I'm gonna work my way up, yeah, setting me a false hope. But what I'm saying is this. He told me months and years, go to school, do what you have to do, do what you have to do. Now, I finished high school. Went on 12 years, finished school. But I didn't pass the HSET test. Actually, when I went to study for it, I actually passed the part that I didn't study for. It didn't fail the part that I studied for. Strange, ain't it? Yeah, they were real strange to me too. But recently, at 29, I'm 29. Be 30 in January. Recently, you can do it too. Recently, I went back to school. Self-study. So I encourage anybody to get their GED or go back and get your high school diploma. You can do it. If I can do it, you can do it. Self-study. I studied at home. I slacked off. Studied at home. Yeah, I did a lot of slacking. Come on, Saints. We all do some slacking too. We don't want to admit it. Yes, we do. But I finally finished. With the help of the Lord, helping my wife, I finally finished. Amen. If it wasn't good for them too, I probably wouldn't finish. But I finally finished. And when I finished, I submitted my paperwork on Monday. I submitted everything I did for the self-study to get my diploma, my high school diploma. Yes, at 29, I am not ashamed. Oh, come on, somebody. Amen. I'm not ashamed. I'm not ashamed. I don't care who goes. Put it on Facebook for all I care. Don't make no difference. I came through my Red Sea, but I finally got it. And when I got it, I submitted the paperwork on Monday. Matter of fact, I submitted it late. We submitted it real late. We didn't expect to get it to the following week. How about the paperwork came back that Saturday? The folder came in. It was real thick. I said, oh, my Lord. I know I've been out of school for almost about 11 years. Oh, my God. The paperwork come back. The folder real thick. I'm like, oh, Jesus. Pull out the pencils. Pull out the calculator. I know I done filled up the math. Yeah, because I was guessing on it. I was guessing on the math. Yes, I really was guessing on the math. Mm-hmm. But I did the same thing I did when I took HSET. Focus more on the vocabulary. Well, if I get a D in math, so what? How about this? It happened again, Saints. I end up acing the math, making a B in the vocabulary. And I know I was guessing on the man. Come on, somebody. That ain't nothing but God. And I'm closing. And the paperwork that came back with the diploma, it was paperwork that I did so well on, the people was, they was astonished. And I showed my wife on the report, she thought I was lying. I said, no, baby. I said, look at this. And she was like, oh my God, that's the same one I thought you was gonna fail on. That's the same one you got an A on. Come on, somebody. And I know my handwriting ain't pretty, but I know how to make sense. I know how to get the point across. And what I'm saying is this, I'm gonna encourage somebody, and I'm getting ready to go to school. I got some people in the making helping me get in college. Amen. Clapping, amen. Thank God, amen. Amen. I'm glad. I'm glad. I'm proud of you. Amen. Because I know I came from a long ways. And not saying that to be boastful, but truthful, because I remember the dark days and the days I felt like quitting and giving up and being street and being like, I've done all that, plus some more. I got pictures to prove it. But all I'm saying is, don't let the Red Sea hinder you from getting to your promised land supply.
Oh, that's good. That's what I mean. I've heard him preach many, many messages. But this one this morning, it really did something with me. When he brought me the diploma, I looked at it, and tears was almost in my eyes. I didn't know how I was to respond. But I thought about the days of encouragement. Just keep saying to him, go back and get this. Go back, go back. And he got it. Now, that's my son, and I'm proud of him. So, you know what? I'm happy that he done that. But what he's saying to some of you, it may not be your high school. It could be some other things, some other issues. But whatever it takes in order to help make your life better.
Yes, sir.
To make your life more complete. I told him, I said, give it as a testimony. Because it's going to help somebody.
Yes, sir.
You know, we always trying to tell people how they're going to get to heaven. But what about helping them to learn how to live here on earth?
Come on.
We live right now. In the now generation. That's why I want to encourage many of our young people. The Lord is blessing us with a lot of young people between the age 18 up to 40. Now we've got some other people. I'm just talking about the age 18 to 40. Your life is really just beginning. Dr. Todd Koontz, some of y'all see him on TV. He be on camp meeting. He is 44 years old. You want to talk about FedEx and UPS blessings. You cannot be hindered and stopped from doing things in life unless you hinder yourself. So don't let your high school diploma, he said he's going to school now, he's going to college, he's already made up his mind about that. Because in the near future where we are now, if you don't have a something even a little bit better than a high school diploma, at least an AA degree, a bachelor degree, you almost need that right now in order to get a good job, to really qualify for a good job. The rest of us that were fortunate enough, like we got some people been on their job 27 years working in certain fields, and they were just blessed. They were just blessed people. But if some of them had to go back today and qualify up under the same domain that they qualified for 20-some years ago, then the thing might be just a little bit different. I'm talking about today. If you apply for the same position today, you'll find out the curriculum, the requirements is a little bit different. So we want to help this church. We want to help people in this church. I don't care what people say about us. We know where we're at. We're in the ghetto. But we can get more. Amen, somebody. Don't worry about who you are. Don't let people belittle you and put you down. There's one thing about your bishop, your pastor, I won't let nobody stop me from doing what I know God has qualified me to do. Nobody. You got to go for it. So if you hear that, we have some other people that say they want to be a part of this ministry. If you still think you want to be a part of Christ's Open Doors, you think you want this to be your church home, and don't you try to figure out how long it's going to be. If you want to come today, we want you to come. We want to receive you as a part of this church family. If you're here today, whosoever will, let them come.
Amen.
We'll open the doors of the church. If you want to come, come.
Amen.
Anybody want to come? Your name is great. have me doing it well.
I love to worship at your throne, Lord, at your feet I'd bow my knees. There's no place that I would rather be. I love to worship, love to worship. I love to lift my hands and praise. I love to worship. I love to worship.